I know. Still nothing going on, but I'll have you guys know. I brushed my teeth for you. And you can't even smell anything.
Do 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 do, this is a theme song.
Hi guys, it's Academy Awards season and I saw one of the nominated films for the Animated Feature category. At this point I've actually finished the category since there are only three films. Toy Story 3, How to Train Your Dragon, and the film I saw, The Illusionist. The Illusionist is a French-British co-production, but to most, at least to me, I didn't know that because its director, producer, writer is French. I'm going to horribly mangle his name, but his name is, I believe, Sylvain Chomet, and he directed the Academy Award-winning film The Truants of Belleville, which came out a number of years ago. The movie follows the story of an aging magician who is forced to perform in increasingly remote venues due to the rise of television and rock and roll and sort of the fading of vaudeville and stage show performances. Set in the late 1950s, early 1960s, and there's sort of a shift in what the public was looking for in terms of entertainment. The Illusionist ends up in an isolated fishing community in the upper reaches of Scotland, and meets a young girl who believes that he's actually a real musician. She runs away from town and follows him to Edinburgh, where she begins the process of discovering herself and the greater world around her, while the magician is forced to continue to keep up the illusion of having real magic powers while providing for the two of them on the meager money he can make from his shows and the odd jobs he tries to conceal from her. I really enjoyed this film. I always think it's interesting to see animated fare from outside of the US because what we know is so dominated by Disney and, to a lesser extent, animated films from Japan. So it's cool to me to see a film that's from outside those two centers, really, of animation, and I really appreciated seeing not only a foreign perspective, but a foreign perspective presenting a medium that is sort of classically assumed to be hugely American. I really admired this film for its straightforward handling of difficult topics such as the loss of innocence, which it sort of takes on a number of levels. It's not just about the young girl discovering ultimately that there is no real magic in the world. It also has to do with his own discovery that the world that he had built around him and the world that he had made a name for himself in is changing dramatically. Now, all three of the nominated films sort of deal with this theme of growing up, of being faced with tremendous change and sort of how you react to that. But Toy Story 3 and How to Train Your Dragon take a very different, and I would say very American, approach to this. The other two films seem to suggest that we are ultimately stronger for our acceptance of change, and that giving in to the decisions made for us by other people ultimately limits our potential. In the case of Woody accepting being donated to the daycare facility, or the idea that the people in your village say you can't slay dragons because you're too much of a shrimp to do so. But The Illusionist doesn't give us a sort of straightforward answer on this idea of how do we handle change that we can't combat in any way. Instead, it closes with an almost sorrowful acknowledgement of the inevitability of growing up. The other thing that really sets The Illusionist apart from the other two films is Chomet's trademark lack of dialogue. The story is mainly told through a series of grunts, of verbal gestures that match the visual cues on screen, and the occasional smattering of different languages that show up in a word here, a word there. It certainly helps to sell the movie to global audiences because you don't have to deal with subtitles. And at times, it actually is a very powerful tool for keeping the viewer's attention. To me, this was a major contrast to the other two films because one of the things I admired most about Toy Story 3 and How to Train Your Dragon was their excellent screenplays. The lack of dialogue also had a negative effect for me, which was due to the film's mundane setting and relatively slow pacing. At times, the lack of dialogue just ended up slowing down the piece and made its 90-minute runtime feel significantly longer. There's certainly part of that that is admirable to make a film that is not easily digested and deals with real people in real situations. But ultimately, what it comes down to for me is The Illusionist just never really grabbed me emotionally. It was interesting to watch in a sort of anthropological way of seeing another culture's films. It was interesting to watch because I've actually never seen The Truants of Belleville, and I was wondering how the lack of dialogue would feature into this. But I never felt a sense of real sorrow or real exhilaration. I felt always sort of removed from the film, and to me, it was not visually or thematically complex enough for me to be okay with that distance. So in the end, if I were in the Academy, I would probably still vote for Toy Story 3. But The Illusionist gets a 3.5 stars out of 5 for me. It was a solid film, and it was definitely not a waste of my evening. Thanks for watching Totally Judgy. I'll catch you sometime soon. Also, if we're gonna be totally judgy for a second, movie tickets should not cost more than $10, and it is absurd how much you have to pay in New York City.